If for some reason chapters are not working, I'm pinning a comment with timestamps to all the settings, so you can just click on what you want to see instead of watching the entire video. Now let's get to the point. Anisotropic filtering, set it to 2x since it doesn't really affect important textures all that much. So just extra performance at no visual cost really. Level of detail, keep it on high. Don't feel too bad if you have to drop it all the way down since it only affects small portion of in-game geometry. You'd normally expect decent performance improvement from dropping shadows, but for some reason I couldn't get any FPS boost whatsoever, so keep them on high. Textures, as always, give you nothing if you have enough VRAM, so keep them on high. If you turn off screen space reflections, you will get only around 1.5% boost, even though it seems like there is a lot of reflective surfaces, so I'd honestly just leave it on. Motion blur is a free 1% more FPS, so turn it off. Radial blur will really only make any kind of a difference in very specific scenarios, but since it's another type of blur, I'd turn it off. Chromatic aberration is another one that doesn't really give you much, but since you won't notice any visual difference while playing, why not turn it off? Turning lens flare off is actually going to give you a small boost, which I would do, but just look at the comparison and decide since you might want it on. Even though you won't really notice any depth of field during normal gameplay, only during cutscenes, it still gives you around 3.5% performance boost when it's turned off. But on the other hand, you are going to lose the cinematic look during some cutscenes, not all of them, so decide for yourself. Light scattering, basically like volumetric fog, makes almost no difference in graphics, so set it too low for extra frames. DLSS in this game is looking great. If you have an NVIDIA GPU, definitely set it to quality for extra 40% performance. But if DLSS is not an option in your case, then to get the same performance, just drop resolution scale to 80%. If you decide to do it though, I would recommend applying a hefty amount of fidelity FX sharpening, or else the game is going to look quite blurry. Ray tracing in this game looks good, but it is really overtuned. It's applied even on very diffused surfaces where you can barely see any reflections, annihilating frames in the process. Numbers you see here are from RTX 3080 and ultra ray tracing in some places drops even lower than that. But if you want to use ray tracing for that extra oomph to the visuals, just set to high cause it still looks really good. This game doesn't really go overkill with highest settings where you lose like 10% performance for no reason with one silly setting, which is nice, but on the other hand, this video might be a bit pointless since overall performance gain isn't as high as I would like it to be, but here we are. Almost forgot, of course set your game to full screen exclusive mode for extra stability and in some cases more frames.